All right, ladies, here we go. We've got the top six answers on the board. I'm telling you right now, the Commodores had this same outfit on.
I would believe
it. Back in 1975. I wanted that right there. All right, here we go. If you had a pumpkin for a head, name something someone might try to do to it. JoJo.
Yes! Sorry, I got really excited. Carve it.
Carve it.
Supposed to.
Pass or play?
We're gonna play.
I knew it. Jaden, she got the number one. That's genuine excitement.
I'm so happy.
All right, here we go. If you had a pumpkin for a head, name something somebody might try to do to it.
Maybe smash it?
Smash it.
There you go. Yeah!
Good answer.
Tommy Tuna. The big T. All right, man. If you had a pumpkin for a head, name something someone might try to do to it.
Try to get into it, Steve, to see what they're thinking.
Get in there. See what you're thinking. See what you're thinking.
We got a few more.
The boss lady, leader of the pack, how are you?
So good.
Good. If you had a pumpkin for a head, name something someone might try to do to it.
Eat it.
Try to eat it. Hello, Miranda.
Hey, Steve.
All right, let's go. If you had a pumpkin for a head, name something someone might try to do to it.
Maybe put some candy in it.
Put some candy in it.
That's hard.
That's a hard one.
All right, JoJo, we got two strikes now. We got to be careful. D'Amelio family can steal. All right, JoJo, if you had a pumpkin for a head, name something someone might try to do to it.
Steve, I'm gonna go with paint it.
Oh! Try to paint it! Yeah. Jaden, we got two strikes, man. We gotta be careful. D'Amelio family can steal. Hey, Jaden, if you had a pumpkin for a head, give me something somebody might try to do to it.
Steal it? They might try to steal it?
Try to steal it. Snoop, this could be either... This could be something really good or you about to be on YouTube. Oh, they ready though. Hey, listen to me. Robin did pretty good though, Snoop. She got 141.
What?
Yeah. You need 59 to win. And we're gonna put $25,000 into that football league for you. All right? This is how we're gonna do it, Snoop. I'm gonna ask you the same five questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again. They got it right. Hey, that's all right. He knew right where it went on time. I'll say try again, then you give me another answer. Gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we'll give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's remind everybody of Robin's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. We asked 100 women, how much does your purse weigh?
3 pounds.
Name a salad dressing you'd find at most salad bars.
Ranch.
Try again.
French.
Name something that happens in the month of April.
April Fool's.
Fill in the blank, pie in the what?
Horse.
Name a color in a traffic light.
Red.
Yeah. Let's go, Snoop. Sure hope we get down to that one, because I don't know what the hell you said, but sure hope we make it to that one. We need 59. We ask 100 women, how much does your purse weigh? You said 3 pounds. Survey said 5 pounds was the number one answer. We need 51. Name a salad dressing you find at most salad bars. You said French. Survey said? All right. Ranch. Ranch was the number one answer. We need 30 points. Name something that happens in the month of April. You said April Fool's Day. Survey said. Well, sometimes God hears and answers prayers. I now get to find out what the hell he said. We need 1 point. Fill in the blank. Pie in the what the hell did you say? What? Pie in the what? In the horse. Folks, when your brain cells have when your brain cells have suffered a little bit, you're gonna have moments like this. This is going to be on YouTube. Cause Snoop just said, pie in the horse. The hell is he talking about? We need 1 point. I need one other person in this world who, for some reason, has found a pie stuck up inside a horse, cut it, and served it to the people. Survey says, yes. We need 1 point. Name a color in a traffic light. You said red. Survey said. Yeah. Sugar Ray, Snoop Dogg, and their families for coming on Celebrity Family Feud. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time. And get yourself some pie in the horse. Welcome back to Celebrity Family Feud, everybody. The Kardashian family once again. It's time to play
Fast Money.
All right. For the first time in the history of Family Feud, we have an announcement. Chloe?
Well, Kim and Kanye were dying to do this, and they really thought they were going to win. They didn't. But as sisters, Kendall and I are deciding to let them play Fast Money because it's going to the same charity. Yeah.
So they're gonna step aside, cause it's always been Yeezy's dream to play Fast Money. So Kanye West and Kim West are gonna play Fast Money. Who's playing first? Come on, Kim.
I am so nervous. I practice this in my bedroom every single night, but I think in person I'm gonna hopefully not do awful, cause the charity needs it.
Well, here's the thing. It's hard to practice for this game.
Yes, I know.
Because I'm gonna ask you some stuff that's way more ridiculous than what you've practiced for. It's hard to practice for ignorance. It really is.
Okay, it's Children's Hospital, Los Angeles, this is for you.
Yay! Okay, I'm gonna give you a chance. So, Kim, this is it. This is from my man Yeezy. He's off stage. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. If you can't think of something, you just say pass. You and Kanye together come up with 200 points. Look right there and tell them what you're playing for.
$25,000 for the Children's Hospital, Los Angeles.
Yeah. All right, you ready?
Yes.
20 seconds on the clock, please.
Okay.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how sexy are you compared to the people you work with?
10.
Name a part. Yeah, okay, stop. Okay, stop.
Do I get those seconds back?
No, 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 no. We go start off. You just had to get the same answer. I was stunned at the question.
Okay.
Just do it. Yeah, you are. Okay, we could just get the same answer.
Okay.
I have 20 seconds on the clock. You ready?
Yes.
All right, here we go.
Okay.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how sexy are you compared to the people you work with?
10.
Name a part of the body you're always banging into things.
Your butt.
Fill in the blank. Slice of what?
Pie.
Name something a pet hamster spends a lot of time doing.
Running in the wheel.
Name something you need to make a milkshake.
Milk.
Bam. Woo! Bam. Bam. All right.
I did it.
I'm good.
Let's see.
I'm good.
All right, here we go. On a scale of 1 to 10, how sexy are you compared to the people you work with? You said, I'm a 10. I've never said I was a 10, ever. Survey said. Woo! Yeah. Name a part of the body you're always banging into things. You said, your butt. Am I grinning that hard?
No, I've really like knocked things over with my butt before. So this is really true for me.
Bam. Survey said. What?
What?
It's all right.
Here we go. Fill in the blank. Slice of what? You said pie. Survey said. That's a good one. Name something a pet hamster spends a lot of time doing. You said, running on a wheel. Survey said? Yeah. Name something you need to make a milkshake. You said, milk. Survey said? Wow. Good comeback. Thank you. Can win $25,000 for his charity. Coming up, let's bring Kanye out, see if he can win this $25,000. On a scale of 1 to 10, how sexy are you compared to the people you work with? Your wife said 10. You said 10. Then you said... Welcome back to Celebrity Family Feud. Let's bring Kanye out, see if he can win this $25,000. Let's go, Ye. All right, we in business. Wifey did pretty good. Couple of stunning answers, but she did good. Your girl got 147 points.
Ooh.
Kanye, we need 53. We need 53 for the money. This is gonna be good. All right, this is how we're gonna do it. I'm gonna ask you the same 5 questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again, you give me another answer. Gonna be a little bit tougher this time, so we'll give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's remind everybody of Kim's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. On a scale of 1 to 10, how sexy are you compared to the people you work with?
10.
Try again.
5.
Name a part of the body you're always banging into things.
Your knee.
Fill in the blank. Slice of what?
Bread.
Name something a pet hamster spends a lot of time doing.
Being on a spinning wheel.
Try again.
Eating.
Name something you need to make a milkshake.
Milk.
Try again.
Ice cream.
Bam. Come on, Blake. Yeah. Come on. Come on, let's go. We need 53 points for $25,000. On a scale of 1 to 10, how sexy are you compared to the people you work with? Your wife said 10. You said 10. Then you said 5. Survey said 5 and 8 was tied for the top answer. We're 32 away. Name a part of the body you're always banging into things. You said your knee. Survey said. Oh! Yeah, boy. Leg and knee was the number one answer. Pie was the number one answer. Running on the wheel, the number one answer. Milk was the number one answer. They had all the number ones. That's $25,000 for Children's Hospital of Los Angeles. I'd like to thank Kanye, Kim, Chris, and the rest of the family for coming out on Celebrity Family Feud. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks. Chuck, we can do it, though. You ready?
I'm ready.
You got 20 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. We asked 100 married women, if it were up to you, how many nights a week would you make love?
3.
Name something specific on a football player that might be too tight.
Jersey.
Name something you need before you start cooking barbecue.
Charcoal.
Fill in the blank. Fortune blank.
500.
Name a drink that's served both hot and cold.
Tea.
Yeah. Come on, boy, you might have did a little something here.
Good answer.
Yeah, this might be all right. We ask 100 married women, if it were up to you, how many nights a week would you make love? You said 3. Survey said? Yeah. Name something specific on a football player that might be too tight. You said the jersey. Survey said. Name something you need before you start cooking barbecue. You said charcoal. Survey said. Yep. Fill in the blank. Fortune blank. You said Fortune 500. Survey said. Yeah. Name a drink that's served both hot and cold. You said tea. Survey said. Oh, yeah. Good deal, boy. Here comes Shaq.
Yeah. How'd Chuck do? He
did all right? Chuck did all right, man. Chuck got 134 points.
Yeah.
Yeah. You need 66, Diesel. You ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's remind everybody of Chuck's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. All right, here we go. We asked 100 married women, if it were up to you, how many nights a week would you make love?
4.
Name something specific on a football player that might be too tight.
Pads.
Name something you need before you start cooking barbecue.
Barbecue sauce.
Fill in the blank, fortune blank.
500.
Try again.
Fortune cookie.
Name a drink that's served both hot and cold.
Tea.
Try again.
Coffee.
It's over.
You won?
It's over.
About to see. Normally, I put my arm around the person, but this ain't gonna look good. That was a very uncomfortable moment. All right. We need 66 points. Let's go. We ask 100 married women, if it were up to you, how many nights a week would you make love? You said 4. Survey said 1. 1 was the number one answer.
1? Oh, hell no.
You know they tired of you. Stop all this 4 times, 3 times, man. Come on. Name something specific on a football player that might be too tight. You said Vance. Survey said. Diesel, we 9 points away. Number one answer was pants. Name something you need before you start cooking barbecue. You said you need barbecue sauce. He can't even start without knowing where the damn sauce is. Damn the grill, charcoal, where the hell is the sauce? Survey said. Was the number one answer. They had all of them. Well, that's $25,000 for the Mustard Seed School. I'd like to thank Ernie and Jimmy and the rest of everybody, all of you guys, for coming out and joining us in Celebrity Family. All right, you ready? 20 seconds on the clock, please. Here we go. How long should a marriage-minded woman date a guy before giving him an ultimatum?
2 years.
Name something you do in the snow.
Sled.
Tell me a reason you're still in bed at 10 a.m.
You're sick.
What do you think of when you hear the word cougar?
An older woman.
Fill in the blank. Fairy blank.
Pass. Or the last one.
That's the last one.
Oh.
Fairy.
Tail. Just under the gun.
Yeah. Yeah, let's go. Yeah. You're here. You're
here. Oh. I'd like to apologize for
Come
that.
On, Amy.
I'd like to apologize for that.
Turn around. Just walk off. I don't give a damn. I got 25,000. All right, let's go. How long should a marriage-minded woman date a guy before giving him an ultimatum? You said 2 years. Survey said? That's a good one.
Yes,
that's a good one. Name something you do in the snow. You said? You sled. Survey said? All right.
Kim will get it.
Tell me a reason you're still in bed at 10 a.m. You said? You're sick. Survey said? Yeah. Yep. Yeah. What do you think of when you hear the word cougar? You said? An older woman. Survey said?
Yes!
Fill in the blank. Fairy blank. You said? Fairy tale. Survey said? Yeah. Wow. Ah!
Okay.
Clear the board. Bring out Kim. All right, Kim.
Hello.
She did good. She got 186.
Oh, good job, man.
You need 14, Kim.
Okay.
All right, let's remind everybody of Amy's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. How long should a marriage-minded woman date a guy before giving him an ultimatum?
3 years.
Name something you do in the snow.
Ski.
Tell me a reason you're still in bed at 10 a.m.
Pass.
What do you think when you hear the word cougar?
Football.
Fill in the blank. Fairy blank.
Tail.
Try again.
Land.
Tell me a reason you're still in bed at 10 a.m.
Sleeping in.
We need 14 points. How long should a marriage-minded woman date a guy before giving him an ultimatum? You said 3 years. Survey said. Should a marriage-minded woman date a guy before giving him an ultimatum? 2 years. Something you do in the snow, ski. A reason you're still in bed at 10 a.m. You're sick. Cougar, older woman, fairy tale. She'd have got it. Well, that's 25,000 for every town for gun safety. I'd like to thank Kelly and Amy and their families for coming on Celebrity Family Feud.